Please pull it out. If you don't have your cell phone in class, just write the number down. I want you to add this number. I want you to give it some type of contact descriptor like Zap or Zap Lead or Show Me the Money or whatever. Something, when that lead comes in, you know that it's a lead. Now, a lot of agents will do this. They'll assign a special ringtone to the number as well, so you don't even have to look at your phone. You don't have to go, what is this? Who's calling? You can hear that duck quacking or those coins ka-chinging or whatever special ringtone you select.
Don't hang up when it comes this number.
But this is the number you will be called from. So you want to make sure that you know, because there's nothing worse like, I don't recognize that number. I don't know who this is. And then you're like, I don't get any leads.
Which number, I mean, if you have two cell phones, is it attached to both cell phones?
I'm going to show you how you set up your own preferences for your contact information in a second. This is, the call is coming from this number. Mm-hmm. When we get to your preferences and notifications set up, you can determine which number you're contacting. You can't have multiple options, but I'll show you how to designate and make sure that the right phone is getting called. All right, hopefully you've had a chance to either write this down or enter it in your class. In your phone, we're moving forward. Let me just do a check on time. Okay, all right, we're gonna pick up the pace a little bit, so you're warned. follow along. If you get lost, just let me know, hey Roger, I don't know how you got there. So in order to access your account settings, you're going to come over here again to your name and photo. You're going to get the drop-down list, and now you're going to take the account settings option. When you select that, you'll land on the page for your account settings. There'll be four tabs at the top. You'll automatically default to your email settings. We're not going to cover that yet. That's the last thing we cover together. MLS memberships, you had asked me about that. This is where you access your MLS memberships and link up. I don't have time to cover that in class, but this is where you find that information. That's where you can link it up. If you haven't done so already, I'd like you to click on lead zip codes. I'm going to explain what this will tell you. So again, your company has already set you up for leads, broker supplied leads based on zip codes assigned to you. So what you're going to see on this page in the first column will be all of the service markets that we've set up for you in the area. I believe everyone is lumped under Los Angeles. Is that correct? Okay. If you ever want to know all the zip codes that roll up underneath the service market, you can click the expand all button. It will give you a breakdown of it from lead zip codes and service markets tab. So this is the service market set up for you. It will then tell you in the next column how many zip codes have been assigned to you for broker supplied leads. The next column will tell you how many zip codes have not been assigned to you for leads in that service market. The last column is a status column. It will tell you whether that service market is turned on or off for you for broker supplied leads. Green is on, black is off. You can't change this. Already set up in the system. If you want to have it changed, you will work with your Zap specialist or broker to have modifications made. Yes?
If it says the number of zip codes, can you get into that and see which zip codes?
Yes, just click the expand all button for that service market and it will show you the first, it'll show you the zip codes assigned to you, and the second will show you ones that are unassigned.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yep. All right, we're done with that. That's how it's set up. View only, you can't change it yourself. You have to engage your broker or Zap specialist to make any modifications. The next tab I want to show you is the service markets tab. So let's click on that one. Again, service markets, large geographic areas in your region, and Los Angeles is the one you're all looking at on your screen. Service markets control something very different than lead zip codes. So lead zip codes control how you get broker supplied leads. Service markets control your branding, your marketing and contact information when customers are doing searches on your website. When the search results appear, if they are searching in your service market, the one turned on for you, all the branding is about you. It's all about you, your agent photo, contact information. But we don't limit where customers can search. They can search the whole nation, every service market, and if they're searching outside of your service markets, again, when the results appear, if they want information on a particular property, the branding and marketing information is going to be about a company that supports that service market. In the next section of class, I'm going to walk you through setting up all your preferences for notifications and settings. If you want to know whenever a customer is searching outside of your service market, you can turn that notification on. Every time it happens, you get an email. And then from that point, you can have a conversation about referrals and things like that. So I'll show you how to do that. One other thing that service markets control in the system is where you can set up customers for listing alerts. You can only set them up for listing alerts in service markets that are turned on for you. So you, as an example, you could set up a listing alert for the customer in Washington State, you know, if you don't service them. So that's how that's set up. And then customers can do their own searches, they can access everything, but this is controlling kind of your marketing and branding and what you can do in the system. Again, it's view only, you can't change it here. If you see anything incorrect, like, hey, Los Angeles is black, it's not turned on for me. After class, circle back with your Zap specialist or broker, they'll be able to make the corrections for you. You can't do it yourself.
Who's our Zap specialist to be contacting?
I don't know how many or who they will be, but I have a feeling I know someone who might be helping you day to day, might be your Zap specialist.
Do we have your contact information?
Yeah, I'll find a way to blast out my email to everyone.
I'll just put somebody in the hot seat.
Good job.
All right, so we're moving on again. Now, what I just showed you is kind of some of the business rules set up in the system that your company has done. So how leads are routed based on which zip codes are assigned to you. How often you're required to update a broker supplied lead has been built into the system as well. Usually we follow, or most companies follow, a 1-2-3 update rule. So if it's a more active lead, maybe when you accept that lead into your platform, you'll have a window of 24 hours to make first contact. Then maybe the next update might be 5 to 7 days out from there. The next update will be 20 days out from there, and then every 20 days in the system. But Zap tracks it for you, so you'll know where you are in the process. You don't have to maintain it in your own head. And then you can start building follow-up plans that support the update requirements so that you can assign it and the system can always remind you too. And then it also controls, you know, how we rotate through each one of the agents in the database with those lead offerings. Business rules will require you to create or have periodic updates over the life of the lead. I can tell you this, if you are updating your broker supplied leads